Welcome to World Class Championship Wrestling from the world-famed Sportatorium in downtown Dallas, Texas. I'm Bill Mercer. Great to have you with us, and we've got a tremendous main event. The tag team match featuring Kerry and Mike Von Erich against Killer Khan and The Missing Link. And we're bringing you up to date on all the excitement of those feuds that feature Stella Mae French and Andrea the Lady Giant, Killer Khan and Terry Gordy, and that big one right now, Kevin Von Erich and Chris Adams. And we'll have lots more for you here on World Class Championship Wrestling. And we'll be back with Stella Mae French and Andrea the Lady Giant next on World Class Championship Wrestling. Stella Mae French burst on the World Class Championship Wrestling scene in search of her niece, Sunshine. And in the same time, she realized that gorgeous Jimmy Garvin and then Gino Hernandez were the culprits in Sunshine's disappearance. Gino Hernandez, in order to protect himself, called on Andrea the Lady Giant's Nicola Roberts. And as we moved into the Cotton Bowl Wrestling Star Wars, a lot of great and exciting things happened in this feud between the two women. Here's the way they climaxed. As Nicola Roberts ready to go now with Gino Hernandez against Mike Von Erich and Stella Mae French. And suddenly, lo and behold, here comes a helicopter into the Cotton Bowl, and the crowd sits in some excitement and some drama. And with our long lens camera, you can tell who that is right away. The exotic, the exciting, the girl with the face of a thousand expressions. There she is, she's back, Sunshine. Sunshine's back. Well, for a long time, Stella Mae French was searching for her. And now that Stella Mae has joined in the ranks of World Class Championship Wrestling, here is Sunshine back, and this should be a very dramatic, emotional experience, and it is. A great celebration. Even Mike Von Erich getting a kiss from Sunshine. She's back right at the appropriate time here for this match. But now right in the ring, Nicola, and here is Foo. A shot to Stella Mae French. A little taunting of Sunshine as those two ladies point the finger of despair at each other. Well, look at Nicola, she is going hard against Stella Mae French now. Stella Mae, obviously in a great deal of pain. And Gino seems to be enjoying every second of it. Listen to the crowd. Well, Stella's having enough trouble just trying to gather breath right at the moment to get up and beat Nicola. And a choke. David Von Erich, or David Manning, rather. How about Sunshine with a slap on Nicola Roberts. Sunshine working on a chair. Watch this. Wham on Nicola Roberts' head. And it looked like the rope caught some of that, absorbed some of the shock as Nicola went down. But there is Stella Mae putting the count on Nicola. I guess David Manning did not see Sunshine wrap the chair across Nicola Roberts' head. And Gino is furious. Sunshine comforting her aunt. Nicola trying to comfort her head. And Gino has nobody to comfort him. He is furious. He is out of his mind with anger and frustration. Sunshine belting Nicola Roberts on the head with a plastic chair. Fortunately for Nicola, the chair caught the rope and that absorbed some of the shock. Or we might have had to send for an ambulance for Nicola. Well, there's a happy threesome. Stella Mae French.
In 5 minutes and 19 seconds, Mike Von Erich and Stella Mae French.
Yes, Mike Von Erich and Stella Mae French, the winners. The dramatic, emotional return of sunshine.
A big day at the Cotton Bowl Saturday.
Great. Did you see Val?
Yes.
Oh, hey, man, she came in out of the sky. You wouldn't believe it. It was the greatest thing. It was. But the best thing out of the whole thing was when I had that lady giant down. Geno's, wherever he dug, wasn't it? It was great. It was just spectacular. I loved it all.
And the ecstasy in the faces of the crowd when the helicopter came over and all was something to see.
I know. Val really hated to leave. She really did. She was crying and everything else. She went back to Florida. But as we promised, she'd be in my corner. And you couldn't ask for a better thing than the helicopter, I don't think.
But she did have to go back to Florida.
Yeah, she's back in Florida right now.
Not very happy about that, I know.
No. She's calling me almost 3 or 4 times a day wanting to come back and everything else. And we're talking about things, but nothing settled or anything else.
Well, that's certainly something that we might be able to see in the future, then, is the return of sunshine. Well, Gino Hernandez has arrived, and I don't know what he wants.
You were beaten. She was beaten fair and square.
Believe this. Stella Mae has been given a DDT by Andrea. The Lady Giant is down flat, and Gino and Andrea are proceeding to sit on her and cut her hair. This is horrible. Here comes Rick Hazard out. Rick Hazard pulls Andrea off. Stella has been skinned. I don't believe this. Gino taunting. A DDT has been given to Stella Mae. I have never seen anything like this in my life.
Well, I guess that pretty well speaks for itself. Stella Mae, for the first time ever, knocked out and left in the ring.
How sweet it is. Like I said before, it's only right that she got what she got had coming to her. And you know, in the Cotton Bowl, all she had to do was bring that idiot with her little niece, Sunshine, riding a helicopter. Well, I'd like to say, we got even.
Well, surprise, Sunshine. Now, let's keep tempers, huh?
Let me say right now to you, your aunt had what she had coming to her, and if you know what's good for you, if you know what's good for you, you'll take your little rear end there and go back to Florida where you belong.
You just hold on just 1 minute, Mr. Hernandez. You've made a big mistake. As a matter of fact, you've made 2 big mistakes. And I'll tell you why. Because number one, what you did to my Aunt Stella Mae, she will never forget. Do you understand me? She is mad. Number two, now you have me to contend with.
What do you think you're going to do about you?
Some climactic moments in the drama and the feud of Stella Mae French, Andrea, the Lady Giant, and Sunshine. And I'm sure we're going to see more of the conflict of those three on World Class Championship Wrestling. Speaking of conflict, there was a tremendous amount of it at the Cotton Bowl Wrestling Star Wars. One was one-on-one, arm wrestling. Here it is in all its excitement.
I'll take my time, sucker. You sit down.
Well, Butch Reed is not exactly your cordial, considerate type individual, is he? And of course, a lot of this is mental. You gotta believe.
I'm gonna break your arm, buddy.
You've got to believe. Arm wrestling championships are really something now. You've seen them on television. Well, here is an arm wrestling championship.
Hey, you know what you're doing? You know what you're doing? Okay, but you get it lined up right, all right?
And Rick Hazard setting it up now.
Hey! You tell us something. I found something on the damn table a little bit. You understand?
And again, still psyching, still working. Hazard.
Shut up! Sit down, dog.
Now moving around.
Sit down, dog.
All right. Butch Reed may be ready. And all you have to do here is just watch. Watch.
Look at her.
Very carefully. The picture tells the story.
Wait.
A little dispute there over whether it was ready or not.
You keep your hands yourself, Tump, or you wind up like Kevin did. Kevin, his hand laid all wide open. Sit down, boy. Sit down, boy.
You can certainly see why Hacksaw has the nickname Hacksaw. He is not exactly a quiet, not assertive person.
Get his arm off here where mine is.
The idea is, of course, to get the same leverage. Don't want to give any. Very carefully controlled. Go, that's the term, go. Hacksaw with a very distinct early advantage.
What's he gonna do, boy?
Gary coming back. Gary coming back. They're up even again. Gary's taking it away from him right now. Gary's moving over the other side. Boy, this one could go for a long time, although Gary seems to be taking it to him. A little extra effort in there by Hacksaw. Tremendous, tremendous exertion. Not quite, not quite. Gary just above the table. Now it's back again. How white. Blood rushing out. Pressure in Gary's hand. Extreme, extreme effort. Gary Von Erich and Hacksaw Butch Reed. They really work it back and forth, back and forth. Tremendous muscular agility of both of these men. Cannot lift the elbow off the table. With the referee watching very carefully. They can use that other arm as a lever on the other side. Let's wash back and forth, back and forth. $5,000 arm wrestling championship. Very close. Gary, very close. He wins it. Gary Von Erich has defeated Hacksaw Butch Reed. See if it's going to be one out of three, or are they going to. Is that it?
No! That table sucks!
Well, maybe the table collapsed. I'm not sure. They're still discussing it. And Butch Reed doesn't like the table.
Gary Von Erich took the three down, that's for sure. Ah, Butch Reed kicked the table out. They had that tight shot on the arms, and it was not a victory. He knocked the table out. So the referee is apparently on top of it and says it is no contest at this moment because Reed kicked the table leg out. Did not see that part of it. We saw the arm go down, but didn't see Reed kick the table. So they go back to continue. And we watch carefully again now as they start. Same spot, hand of the referee in. Go, and they're off again. And Reed, taking the advantage early as he did when this bout first opened. Is a tremendous amount of exertion. The crowd chanting. Very close. And down again goes the table. And Reed once again goes out. The table went down. See if this is going to be the final decision or not. And the winner, Gary Von Erich. So with the pressure of Gary Von Erich's arm. I think he again kicked the table. And it appeared, though, that Kerry Von Erich's arm had taken Reed down. And Reed evidently kicked the table again and was disqualified by the referee. And Reed is a very, very upset young man, not only losing $5,000, but losing physical superiority face. Oh, Hacksaw Butch Reed. And Reed comes back in now.
Table right there.
And we'll be back with more World Class Championship Wrestling in just a moment. Freebird Terry Gordy was befriended by Killer Khan in the Orient. And in return, Terry Gordy helped Khan come to the United States to wrestle. But then Terry found out that friendship is a fragile instrument. Khan went over to Devastation Incorporated, and the feud was on. But it certainly appeared that there wasn't very deep friendship for Khan because he took money from Akbar and became a friend there.
Well, I guess that's his friends. You know, like I said, his main friend was Bam Bam, and that's what made him our friend.
Well, I want to talk to Terry. He's back here. Well, I just... Terry's his real friend. Terry, could you...
Hey, back up.
See, I told you.
Don't be putting your hands on this fan. This fan belongs to us. Nobody puts their hands on this fan but us. If I want to hit this fan, I'll hit it.
I understand.
You understand that? If I want to take a dip of snuff right here and spit it on the ground, I'll spit it on the ground. If I want to bring a friend of mine from Mongolia over here or Japan, anywhere, if I want to bring them right here to Texas, or if I want to bring them to Nashville, Tennessee, if I want to bring them to Boston, I'll bring them. You understand that?
I understand. It looks like your friendship wasn't very deep.
Listen to here. Man, no friend of mine is going to mess with my brother. Do you understand
that?
That's
right.
Talk to him.
Hey, and let me tell you this, man, especially 3-on-1, three of them trying to jump on my brother. Hey, man, why don't they come here now?
Well, he is certainly up.
Now, see, I told you not to.
What's the matter with them now? Where are they at now?
I don't really know
here
right
now.
Here
we are.
Yeah, yeah, here we are. If they want to get it over to the park tonight, we'll get it over
to the is upset.
I told you. Bam Bam, chill out. Now,
don't be fast.
Don't cuss. Don't cuss.
Don't be putting your hand on my van.
All right. Reverse drop. One, two, and not quite enough for three. David Manning is into the ring to talk to Brock Lesnar. As something is coming off, but I don't know exactly what it is. And Irwin fighting through Manning as these two evidently are going to be stopped right here. I do not know what this is all about, but maybe David Manning can clear it for us.
We're going to have to halt this match right here. It will continue after the next match. Terry Gordy and Killer Khan have had a fight in the back. If we don't bring him to the ring right now, the match will not take place. We'll bring Terry Gordy and Killer Khan to the ring now. This match will follow the main event. We will. If you keep on, you'll be disqualified and this match is over.
Well, you saw and heard. Evidently, there must have been a semi-war in the dressing room. Because David Manning has come in, and this is a highly unusual, highly unorthodox procedure to halt a bout. Mike Von Erich and Wild Bill Irwin being stopped, and here comes Gordy, bloodied up along with Michael Hayes. Gordy, who is absolutely livid over the fact that Killer Khan had left their side, giving up the friendship that he exhibited, and went with Devastation Incorporated, Skander Akbar. So Gordy, bloodied after this, what had to be probably a wall-breaking battle in the back, in the dressing room area. Killer Khan and Gordy, there is just absolutely no telling what the damage looks like, and here's Buddy Robertson. As we await now a total view. Oh, look at this. Michael Hayes slapping Gordy to get, I guess, to get him more angry. I don't see how anybody can be any more angry than Gordy has been. Michael Hayes, Buddy Roberts, and Terry Gordy awaiting now the arrival of Killer Khan. And here comes Khan. Now, this is a most unusual, most unorthodox manner of handling this, but here they come, Khan and Gordy. And I think all you have to do is just stop and watch, because this is just going to be absolutely a back alley brawl. And I would imagine there'll be very few rules enforced in this, or how could they enforce it with two men away over 600 pounds? Gordy! They may tear each other absolutely to ribbons like two pit bulldogs. Gordy looks like he might try to tear the left ear off Killer Khan right now. Standing outside the ring. All the other combatants who have been held up because of this war between these two. You see, Gordy and Khan met each other in the Orient. It was Khan who taught or helped Gordy learn the Oriental Spike, took him to the man who knew it. They became great friends. It looked like they were going to become longtime wrestling friends. But then Skander Akbar threw a lot of the green stuff on the table, and here is what is the result. An absolute all-out furious contest of two huge men, two gorillas. Oh, Skander Akbar. Skander Akbar coming in. Now Michael Hayes. Here comes Hog Irwin. And this thing's going to break out into an absolute riot in the ring. That's Wild Bill Irwin and Michael Hayes. They've got everything going crazy. And I don't know how in the world anybody's going to get enough help from gendarmes, from police, from security, and from other wrestlers to break this thing up. I wouldn't want to be stepping in between. There goes David Manning down. I just want to say, I wouldn't want to step in between. There goes Brock Lovitz down. There really is very little you can do here except let them fight until they drop. And drop they may as Kahn and Gordy, Irwin and Hayes, Hogg and Hayes, Buddy Roberts, Skander Akbar. And again, the battle goes on. Hayes getting all over Akbar and the crowd loving that. Killer Kahn taking Michael Hayes to task now. Gordy's back. I doubt that you've ever seen anything just like this. This is just absolutely mankind at its worst, mankind at its most vicious, mankind at its dangerous. And they just go all out, and anybody who gets in the way is fair game. Boots are off, bells are ringing, nothing is working. Everybody has gone absolutely wild. Gordy, Kahn, Hayes. Now we got other wrestlers coming in trying to stop this melee. They've got to try to get the system of law and order returned here. Now this thing is going to break out into an absolute vicious, vicious rolling riot.
What's he got? Is that the spike? Yes! The Oriental spike to the throat. David Manning, the referee, right there. Submission or pin situation could go either way. Always dangerous. The Oriental spike. Ring the bell, it's a submission. Hey, who is this? It's Terry Gordy. I don't believe it. Terry Gordy. Terry Gordy, like a bolt out of the blue, is all over Akbar and Kahn. Surprise, surprise. Who would ever have thought this would happen? Gordy, out of nowhere. And it's Kahn now. There's the boot. Gordy takes the boot off and pulverizes anybody that he can get his hands on, including David Manning, who comes to the floor. Oh, boy. This is unbelievable. I've never seen anything. There's a stairway thrown into the ring. Kahn throws a stairway into the ring. Terry Gordy. Remember the feuds that he had with Killer Kahn and the spike. And here we go.
David Manning says that Killer Kahn is the winner of the match.
Killer Kahn won the battle of submission, but what a surprise. The crowd has come to its feet. Rick Hazard knocked down with a boot. And Gordy, like a man possessed. David Manning now thrown again to the floor. And I'm going to leave this right here before some more people get hurt. We'll be back and try to get some order.
The Von Erichs and Chris Adams have long been friends since Chris arrived from England to star on World Class Championship Wrestling. However, a personality change occurred in Chris Adams, and when Kevin and Chris were wrestling together, there was a breakup. This is what happened. And Stella Mae French is back in the arena. David Manning pointing for Stella Mae to get out of there. Gino rolling up on top of Chris. 1, 2, and 3. And Gino Hernandez and Jake the Snake Roberts beat Kevin Von Erich and Chris Adams, and Chris is upset with Stella Mae. I guess in his position, he could see that Stella Mae pulled the leg out from under Gino Hernandez. And Gary Hart
evidently talking rather strongly to Stella May and Kevin. Chris and Gary having a little bit of discussion here now. Gary Hart fires on Kevin, and what's happened here? Stella May popped to the ground. Chris Adams and Gary Hart unloading on Kevin Von Erich, and now Kevin is in trouble, and Chris just walks away. Chris just walks away. That dumbfounds everybody. There goes Gino throwing Stella May out. And they got Kevin Von Erich over here bashing on him, while Gary Hart and Chris Adams have left Kevin to his own chances. A strange, strange turn of events. Jake the Snake and Gino. Oh, there is a neck breaker. Jake the Snake and Gino tearing into Kevin Von Erich. And now some help comes down for Kevin. Here comes Zumhoff. Finally, some help down for Kevin as he was left in the ring, and David Manning was ready to get a chair and run everybody off. But the most perplexing thing is what happened between Kevin and Chris Adams and Gary Hart. Stella May, of course.
Jake the Snake and Gino are winners of the event.
Stella May trying to help Chris Adams and inadvertently help Gino Hernandez. That put Chris into a violent argument with Stella May, and then Gary Hart evidently said something ungentlemanly. Kevin Von Erich decked him, and Chris Adams gave Kevin Von Erich a super kick and then walked away, leaving Kevin to whatever Gino Hernandez and Jake the Snake Roberts wanted.
Well, that was the breakup between Kevin Von Erich and Chris Adams. Since then, we've had the Cotton Bowl Wrestling Star Wars. And that's where Chris Adams struck Kevin Von Erich from behind with a chair, gave him a severe concussion and also a large laceration. We call Kevin Von Erich, ask him to come in for an interview and discuss that incident. This is the way it went.
We invited Kevin Von Erich to come down. I wanted to show him and you the incident when Chris Adams struck him from behind with a chair at the Cotton Bowl Star Wars. Kevin, I'm very happy to have you here. I know there was some question whether you would be able to come down.
A lot of question. If I'm going to come back, if I'm ready, well, let me just assure you and everybody else listening, I am ready. I am back. Man, look what he did to my head. Look at that.
Oh, that's a mean, severe concussion thing there, yeah.
Bill, I'll tell you what. Chris Adams is going to leave the ring the same way that I left that ring. Do you know how degrading it is to an athlete to be carried from the field? In all my years of playing ball, I've been hurt and I've been down, but I've always gotten back up. One time a man had to help me off the field, but I have never been carried off the field in my life. That's the most degrading thing to an athlete, and I assure you, I promise you, Chris Adams is going to feel what I felt.
Let me show you and let's look at this tape.
I'm tired of looking at that tape. I've had enough. I'm on my way.
All right, I can understand Kevin's hesitancy to see this tape again, but we'll go ahead and roll that. This is the incident that Kevin was talking about.
Kevin, Chris, with a hit on the break. Well, that's the first real impolite fraction of the rules that we've seen. Chris taking advantage of it. Kevin coming off. Driving up is Chris Adams. A few of the fans for Chris as Chris jams in on Kevin, and maybe now it's open up. Nice side, high side mare move by Chris Adams, who now seems to think he's in control. A super kick, and Kevin Von Erich is out on the floor. A super kick, and Kevin Von Erich is out on the deck of the Cotton Bowl here at the State Fair of Texas. Fan over there with a sign, hand-painted sign. Chris is still number one. Kevin back in. Here comes Kevin. Nice move by Adams. Watch here. Whoa! Kevin almost in our lap as he flies over Chris Adams, who is running. Another. It's a flying drop kick, not a super kick. But Kevin stumbling out of the ring with a chance to rest. A chance to get a little bit. There's Kay Adams flying out between the ropes on top of Kevin Von Erich. And Chris Adams back in. Chris demonstrating all sorts of maniacal moves here as he grabs Kevin and brings him back in. Coming up with a suplex, but Kevin turns it around. Now it's up and over. A shoulder stand. One, two, three. And Kevin Von Erich beats Chris Adams. Kevin Von Erich defeats Chris Adams. Gary Hart is explaining it. Adams had his shoulder was off the mat. Well, Chris is a little upset. And you can certainly understand why he picked up the bell here. Kevin Von Erich, the winner. And Chris Adams feels he was robbed. I was looking for Gary Hart. He's right to my right here. And here's Kevin. I'll see if I can get
Adams. Hey, man. What are you acting that way for? That was a clean match, and I won it fair and square.
Gary Hart right down to my left.
Now, Chris, I'm going to make you a deal. I can't believe myself right now I'm making, but I'll tell you what. You fire Gary Hart. Get rid of him, and I'll try to bury the hatchet and forget it ever happened. Be water under the bridge.
Well, that's an interesting challenge, and Gary Hart is right here to my left.
Chris, here's the microphone. I'm leaving it up to you. Make your own decision.
And Chris is certainly thinking it over. Gary Hart up on the apron of the ring. And Kevin Von Erich hit from behind by Chris Adams. And hammering the chair and on Kevin Von Erich has gone absolutely crazy here. As Gary Hart now looking around, and he wants to get out of here. Kevin Von Erich smashed on the back of the head. Blood running down from the back of his head. He has been terribly hit from behind by Chris Adams. Gary Von Erich in the ring, David Manning in the ring. And Kevin lying on the mat here in front of us as Gary Hart seeks to escape. And escape is a true word because the fans are infuriated. And let's go down to Mark Lorenz.
Ladies and gentlemen, this main event here at the Sportatorium, one fall, 45-minute time limit. First of all, on my right from Mongolia, General Akbar presents the 280 pounds, Killer Khan. Flanking Killer Khan from points unknown at 245 pounds, the Diabolical Missing Link. Across the ring, their opponents. From Denton County, 260 pounds, the modern-day warrior, Kerry Von Erich. Teaming with Kerry tonight, his brother taking the place of Kevin due to what happened to the Cotton Bowl. At 229 pounds, Mike Von Erich. All four men in the ring at the same time, David Manning, your referee. Chick Donovan, glad to see you, sir.
Thank you for this time, Mark. I'd just like to tell all my people here in Texas that I've concurred with the doctors and they've given me a free bill of health on my knee. And brother, I'll be back Monday night. And one more thing I'd like to say is I know Khan's not the one responsible for my knee, Mark. I know it's one Mr. Akbar. And Akbar, you see, I'm dressed in black. And I'm coming back, brother, for all the revenge I tell you one thing. Let me tell you one thing.
Well, away we go here as Chick Donegan and Skander Akbar have their own private war in this four-man. In the ring at the same time also explodes Akbar and Donovan. And it looks like now that Skander Akbar is going to try to break another knee of Chick Donovan. And Donovan claimed that it was Akbar who was responsible for it. Meanwhile, the rest of the battle, the official battle goes on, and Akbar is certainly trying to put Donovan out of his circulation again, going to the opposite knee, and now it is Gary Von Erich and Killer Khan left in the ring. Mike Von Erich shaking up from the missing link. Skander Akbar and Chick Donovan continue to have it there. Battle over here, and poor Chick Donovan may come out of this with two bad knees. Now Khan is strangling Donovan. Link. Here comes Gordy. Terry Gordy arriving on the scene, getting his revenge from Khan. Gordy, who has suddenly appeared, has come back to personally destroy Killer Khan. Gordy, who has his running feud, as we showed you earlier, takes off his boot. He's got Skander, and he's got Khan, and throws Khan into the fans. Donovan checking his knees while the missing link and Mike Von Erich continue to battle. The link has been put out of action for a moment. And Chick Donovan wearing over his knees again. But Terry Gordy, who exploded on the scene just recently, coming by. There's a double drop kick on the link. It'll be hard to separate all this, but Gordy and Khan still on the floor, ready to do their battle. He showed you, you know, that Gordy and Khan used to be friends. And let's go now to Mark Lorenz.
In 1 minute and 18 seconds, both sides are thrown out due to absolute mayhem.
Mayhem it is, and we'll be back with more World Class Championship Wrestling as the mayhem continues. We're here with Terry Gordy, who has seemed to come back for a big reason.
Well, that's right. I got one reason in mind and one reason only, and that's Skander Akbar and all his group. You know, I was sitting around home trying to take a vacation, just got back from Japan, trying to relax a little bit, and what do I have? I have people coming up to me saying, hey, I heard Akbar and Khan run you out of Texas. Well, let me tell you something, Bill Mercer, that don't nobody run me nowhere. When somebody come up to me and said that, I ran all the way back to Texas here just so I could get a piece of the action, and I want some of Killer Khan. Akbar, you remind me of a fly flying around. All I have to do is take a fly swat to you, boy, and I don't want nobody standing in my way, because I don't care about no Von Erichs. I don't care about nobody here. All I want is you, Khan. You bring yourself
World Class Championship Wrestling again next week. We'll see you.